When these babies rolled off the assembly line in 1927, a new industry was born. I'm not talking about the car industry, I'm talking about the road industry. Texas has 79,000 miles of farm-to-market roads, state, U.S., and interstate highways. That's more than any other state. In fact, in 1946, they added the Good Roads Amendment to the Texas Constitution, saying that 3/4 of the revenue from state gasoline tax was going to go to roads and administrating public safety laws. This dedicated fund assured a constant stream of income for those industries connected with highway construction. But we're not in the 1920s anymore, or even the 1950s. Today's problems related to traffic are complex and call for more than one solution. But as long as career politicians are funded by the highway construction industry, guess which solution they're going to go with, first, foremost, and every time. Because when all you've got is a hammer, everything looks like a nail.
Cruising in their Model A, they don't give a darn about what you say. They think building more roads has got to prevail, because when all you have is a hammer, everything is a nail. Sure, there's Aggies who know better, master transportation to the letter. But building roads is their holy grail, because when all you have is a hammer, everything is a nail. What about safety? What about cost? They don't care, they just want to be the boss. For big payoffs, they're setting sail, because when all you have is a hammer, everything is a nail. Pollution, safety, and congestion. We need more than just the same old suggestion. Snake oil only cures the snake. There's another road we need to take. I'm Sheri Saltis, and when I'm elected, I'll make sure we're all protected. From solutions that are unjust, we'll hold the hammer instead of the hammer holding us.